This is the story about our science fair by Hasham Dhakwala and Jason Carter Reynosa. We found out at the end of August 2013 that we had to do science fair. We thought and thought and thought and thought even more about what we should do. But we couldn't figure anything out. We used our interests. One of my main interests was about cars, so we thought of something having to do with cars. The due date was coming up real soon, and we kept thinking and thinking, but couldn't figure anything out. Then one night, I had a dream, and Einstein gave me the idea I was looking for. We looked at our surroundings. We saw the highway and the cars that we used in our everyday lives. We already knew about global warming and the greenhouse effect. This deeply interested us, and we were trying to find ways where we could incorporate cars and natural resources to do something that would help the environment. Cars released a lot of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas. Greenhouse gases would trap heat from the sun and would melt the ice caps at the North and South Pole, resulting in global warming. We thought of all the renewable resources like solar energy, hydropower, geothermal, wind energy, and biomass energy, and we finally settled on solar energy. We didn't really want to make a car that just ran on solar power. We wanted to make something unique. We thought of flying cars, our future. But then again, history has shown us otherwise. When you look in the past, you see boats before airplanes. So how can you make a car that flies before making a car that can drive on water? Even though amphibious vehicles exist, vehicles that can run on both water and land, they don't incorporate natural resources like solar energy. So, we decided to make our own amphibious vehicle that runs on solar energy. We got all of our parts ready, started building it, then we had to wire it so it would work with either solar energy or battery energy. And at the end, the car looked awesome. So we tested it out. We put the car on water in a pool and ran it. It worked really well with either solar energy and battery energy. We also tested it on flat ground. We also tested it on slopes. This was to see if it were real, could it drive on a highway. For our hypothesis, we decided that the solar power would do better. Looking at our results, the solar power component did do better. The best surface for this car was a flat surface, which resulted in better speeds. At the end, solar energy won a very close race against battery power. And at the end, it was all worth it because we won first place.